Recently, I led a Lego robotics camp at a local coding academy, and I was able to borrow their Spark Prime kit to play with over the weekend. So in this video, I want to give a complete overview of the kit and compare it to the old EV3 sets. Hopefully, this comparison will help anyone who is considering switching from the EV3 or any new team who is looking for the set. To compare the kits, they are going to be judged in three main categories. The overall pieces included versus the price of each kit, the hardware, including performances of the electronics, and finally the programming, to see how easy it is to learn these programming softwares and overall how effective they are. First, we're going to compare the kit's worth solely from a LEGO pieces standpoint. So the main components included in the Spy Prime set are a programmable hub, one large motor, two medium motors, one color sensor, one force sensor, a distance sensor, a ball caster, four rubber wheels, which are actually really nice since they aren't tires that can deflate over time, two large building panels, two 11x15 frames, two 7x11 frames, two 5x7 frames, and finally four constructing panels. And some of the unique pieces, apart from the frames of course, which make the original 5x7 frames look tiny, are these new biscuits that can be really useful for connections, and these new 28 tooth gears. Compared to the EV3, the main difference is that the EV3 contains more of these small connection pieces, whereas the Spike Prime has a lot more large connection frames, which I prefer. However, both kits come with the same number of motors and sensors, and a similar number of beams. But overall, I would have to say that as far as pieces, the Spike Prime set is a lot more worth it at a price of $340, mainly because LEGO is discontinuing the production of the EV3 set, so you're probably going to have to pay a lot more for around the same number of pieces. However, even if these sets cost the same, I would still have to say the Spike Prime set is better due to all of the new frames and unique connections. The next category is hardware. The main difference between the two sets of electronics are the overall shapes. The Spike Prime set is sleek and much more compact in size, whereas the EV3 is much larger and bulkier. As far as motors go, the Spike Prime motors are simply more upgraded, having two connections from both sides, a pre-measured starting point, which means that the motor can consistently turn to exact positions, and a unique cutout for the wire that prevents any wasted space. However, as far as performance, the EV3 motors, although not as accurate and consistent, are a lot more powerful and can spin faster. So overall, the EV3 is better suited for larger robots or robots with larger attachments, while the Spike Prime set is better suited for smaller, more agile robots. The two LEGO sets contain the same amount of sensors, each having a color, distance, gyro, and touch sensor. However, Spike Primes are much more precise. Instead of a touch sensor, the Spike Prime has a force sensor that can detect increments of force in newtons, and although this doesn't make much of a difference for FLL, it is much more precise than the touch sensor that can only measure if it is bumped or fully pressed. The second difference is the gyro sensor. Spike Prime doesn't come with a separate sensor like the EV3 because it has a built-in 6-axis gyro in the programmable hub. This makes the Spike Prime gyro far more accurate than the EV3's, not only because it doesn't have gyro drift, where the EV3 gyro has to be rebooted, but because it can detect yaw, pitch, and roll. So, as far as sensors, Spike Prime definitely beats EV3. Lastly are the bricks. Apart from Spike Prime's hub being far more compact and easier to build with, compared to the EV3 brick's awkward shape, as well as its faster boot time, personally, I still like the EV3 brick because of its screen. The Spike Prime hub has this large LED screen that can display numbers and shapes for up to 19 programs, however, I still prefer EV3's screen that can display specific text. Using text to spell out the difference between various programs such as Linefaller version 1 versus version 2 is a lot easier on the EV3 brick compared to how you have to memorize which number or symbol correlates to which program on the Spike Prime hub. Another reason I like the EV3 brick is because it has 8 separate ports compared to the hub only having 6 ports. This doesn't make a huge difference because the Spike Prime does have its own built-in gyro, but the EV3 can have 8 separate motors and sensors while Spike Primes can only have 7. Also, I like how the EV3 electronics have removable cables, which allow for you to switch out different length wires in case you need the motor or sensor to be placed further away, whereas the Spike Prime's electronics have built-in wires. In addition, EV3's ports have much deeper connections for the cables, so the brick saves a little bit more space in the hub. Finally, we have programming. Solely from a learning standpoint, the Mindstorm's programming is slightly easier to learn for anyone new because of its drag and drop blocks. You simply have to input values into the various blocks and assemble them sequentially. Now, although the Spike Prime app also has drag and drop programs, it is more similar to Scratch in real life programming where you have to understand if-else statements, loops, as well as events. However, the Spike Prime programming is definitely more rewarding to learn since it follows similar rules to real life syntax. In addition, because the Spike Prime electronics are more advanced, it's much easier to program more precise runs using Spike Prime, such as how you can define one rotation depending on the size of your wheel, how you can program the motor to spin to a predetermined position, and how you can use upgraded sensor values in your programs. Overall, I think the choice between these two sets also depends on your team's playing style, since the EV3 is more suited for larger builds, whereas the Spike Prime set produces smaller, more compact robots. EV3 motors are much better at powering larger contraptions, whereas the Spike Prime is much more focused on precision and consistency. I would say anyone who currently has an EV3 set shouldn't feel the need to switch due to an unfair advantage, as I think that there are many ways to improve the EV3's weaker areas, such as learning how to build more compact robots and learning to program more complex programs to make up for the EV3's inconsistencies. However, for any new teams, the Spike Prime set is a great option that is designed to make the building and programming process easier because of its compact electronics as well as its upgraded sensor inputs.